YouTube is his making. The first one is better, I think. You call a good game for letting me see their channel. The uploads, I'm a pretty small YouTube channel. I just started. But I have great content, great YouTube videos, HD content, and my link shall be in the description. First, I want to start off by talking about the gameplay before I get into my topic. And actually, it's a very serious topic. It's about people, like the killing that goes around, police brutality, and the different cities that it's in. But first, I'm going to talk about the gameplay. It was a 995, 100 plus fail, a nuclear fail. This whole video, this whole gameplay, which is an all-out fail, with the M27 silenced in stock, running, I think, toughness, scavenger, with the perk, hardline, probably dexterity. But as I was talking about, police brutality and certain things that happen in different cities. Where I'm from, police brutality is a common, actually a common thing. Like, there was one time these two boys, they was in their car driving home. His brother had a gun on him, but he didn't use it. They were going to their mom's house or their dad's house when the police pulled them over because there was two black kids in the car. And the police, not to mention, didn't even go to jail for this. None of them got nothing for this. They're living on their life right now. The two boys were shot down dead in the middle of the street. But also, here's the reason why. They were just going to their house. Now, one of their brothers are criminal. He was in jail before. He smoked weed. Well, not weed, that's fine, but he did drugs. You know, he sold drugs. A common thing down here, actually, in New Orleans. But his brother was just, you know, minding his own business. He never killed anybody, never shot anybody, never did anything. Not a gangster, he's just a person that's misunderstood. So the police took it upon themselves, like Trayvon Martin's story, the police took it upon themselves to go and check it out. So they stopped, they pulled the call over. I guess they felt the kid was doing something. And they just started, they sprayed on him. They just started shooting at him. And I don't even know why. Why would you start shooting at him? He shot at the kids. The one that was sitting in the back seat, one that was sitting in the shotgun, was the oldest. No, the oldest was driving, the one that was in the shotgun was the youngest, and the youngest got out the car and tried to run. And they said he was running because he had something on him, so he started, not to mention, this kid is already shot. So he started shooting at him in his back, and the first time I heard of this, I was like, are you serious? It's the same as the Trayvon Martin story, and this is way before the Trayvon Martin story. The white cops, they got sent to a court, but nothing ever happened to them. People still, well, I don't say whites, but certain people in the city still blame it on the kids for what happened. But they talking about the Trayvon Martin story situation where he fully attacked the man. These kids didn't have a gun on them. The oldest brother did take out a gun and start shooting back. I mean, what if you'd have done that situation? Leave your comment below. What would you have done? Would you have started taking out your gun or try to run, or would you just sat there? Take them two bullets they shot at you. They shot at the kids first. The kids didn't even do anything. Matter of fact, there's another situation where there's a basketball player. He came from the St. Bernard Gym. That's what they call down here, St. Bernard Gym. And he's like 16 years old. This kid had a scholarship to some college. I was cool with him, not best friend, but it was alright. He had a scholarship to a college down here, a big college, D1 and all that, yeah. And he was supposed to go next year after his junior, I think he was a 16-year-old junior, after his junior year. So he was walking home from the seminar gym, just enjoying his day. As he's walking, he noticed that there was somebody in the car following him. And this is from his mouth right before he died. He died in the hospital later on. He had said that he saw somebody following him, that as he was walking, he saw a full-on police car, because you know how they have different type of car, but it was like a white car, and it was just like creeping up behind him with tinted black windows, and it was just standing on his tail, and he was talking about how he got scared, and all this is him talking from the hospital, how he got scared, how he just thought he started walking faster, but then he started running from him, and that's when out of nowhere, they started shooting at him. Now, this kid has no gun on him, no way to defend himself, never did anything, no criminal record, makes all A's in school, he's a 4.0 student, never got in trouble, never, he doesn't even do anything but play basketball, and I seen it, the only thing he asked me to do, I want to do is play basketball. Well, I'm doing a YouTube channel, that you want to play basketball. I was playing football at the time, he was okay for long, but he was just walking, and he started all the mess. Now, some people say the police are doing right by making sure they're checking everybody, but is that okay? Because I noticed out of all the situations that happened, they're not checking, I ain't gonna sound racist about it, but young white kids, they're only checking young black kids. And I'm black, and I'm 17, I don't smoke weed anymore. I don't do none of that anymore. Just saying, like, I know that they're only checking, like, certain people. Like, if you have a tattoo or a dredge or you're black or you're 17 or you're anything like that, I know that they're checking, like, Trayvon Martin situation. A young black kid who never got in any trouble. They found ways to look up stuff that he got kicked out of school for graffiti or some fighting stuff. But that wasn't nothing serious, and they trying to put that on it while he attacked Trayvon. The man. The thing about the whole situation with Trayvon Martin situation, he didn't even attack that man. The man chased him down. What would you do if a guy is chasing him down? Wouldn't you want to fight him? Now back to my situation with the 17-year-old kid. The 17-year-old kid was just walking. And yes, they did attack him. Nothing happened to the policeman. The kid now is dead. They had his funeral, like, I think it was a year ago they had his funeral. I can't think of his name at the moment. And I told you how he talked in the hospital about what happened. So when they went to court, like, what, 2 weeks, 3 weeks after that, the first thing the cops said was that the kid had a gun on him. They planted drugs on him because they found drugs in his pocket. And they later found out the police had planted that on him. Everybody knew the police planted that on him. The boy never did smoke because when they checked his system was clean. But you can obviously tell that he was clean. So I noticed lately that the police not only are going after young black males and females, I'm not going to say they're not going after whites, but all you see is the white policemen and Hispanics going after a number of black kids. And this kid, apparently, who doesn't do anything wrong, still gets wronged in a certain situation that had nothing to do with him. Leave your comment below what you thought about my commentary. Thank you, Kai Gamers, for letting me upload to your channel. Thank you, and bye.